Out. I'm your host, Kim Carey, and it's that special time of year again where we can get out and go to all types of festivals, which is my favorite thing to do. And today, my guests are from the St. Nicholas Greek Orthodox Church, which is the sponsor of the largest ongoing Greek festival in the Metro Detroit area. We have Father Stratton, who is the priest. And we also have Jim Pierce, who is a longtime parishioner. Welcome to Reaching Out.
Thank you, Kim.
So good to have you guys.
Thanks for having us here and to talk about Opa Fest, sponsored by our St. Nicholas Church.
Yes, yes, that's exactly what we're here to talk about. And tell me, what does Opa mean?
Opa. We hear it often, especially down in Greektown, is when you're seeing the saga Nike, the burning cheese, flaming cheese,
the
I should
flaming
say.
Flaming cheese.
And it's just an expression of happiness and joy, being together and sharing a meal together and the great hospitality of our Greek people.
Right, right. Yeah. That is wonderful. So give us some more history about the festival.
Well, the festival's been, this is our 23rd year up in Troy. It's a wonderful time in which we share our church, our faith, our wonderful Greek hospitality, our food, our pastries, our drink, our band, our music. We have over 250 Greek dancers from first grade right up to adulthood in different groups, dancing different dances from the different and various islands of Greece and the mainland. Mm-hmm. It's just a wonderful time.
So you said there are different types of dance. I didn't know that occurred. So do you know what types of dance, different ones?
Well, it's all different types of dances. They come in different steps. They're generally done in groups. We used to call them circle dances. Jim could probably describe a few of them for us.
Yeah. So some of them, for example, from Crete are a little faster and more upbeat. Meanwhile, some of them from northern Greece are a little more flat-footed and very pronounced steps, while the ones in Athens are a little more exciting. And so they all come in a variety of different types of dance.
So instead of line dancing, it's circle.
Yep.
So circle. So everyone's in a circle.
Circle and line.
Okay. Circle and line. Yeah. And do you participate, Father?
I do at the closing.
Well, that should be really, really interesting. So tell us some more, Jim, about the festival.
Well, there'll be a great variety of activities. We'll have activities for adults to see the different entertainment, for example, the band that Father had mentioned, Enigma, will be performing Greek songs of their own, as well as some renditions of classical Greek songs.
There's a special person that's going to be there, too, from the X Factor, the finalist.
Jeff Cook. He's coming in. Give it a little different flavor for the festival.
Okay.
Also supporting one of our own local people. So he's going to come in for about an hour on Saturday night at 8 o'clock. He's going to sign autographs as well.
Wow.
And hopefully bring new people to our Opa Fest who may never have visited us, but are going to enjoy a great evening with both Jeff and all of the activities that will be taking place.
And so, Jim, you are studying right now, doing your graduate work. Tell us about that.
I am. I'm studying right now at the seminary, learning about our Greek Orthodox faith.
Okay.
And just trying to get a deeper understanding for our church and hopefully to one day work for the church in some sort of ministerial capacity. And one way that some of the visitors to our Opa Fest can get an experience of that is through our church tours, which will be happening throughout the weekend in the church. And we'll give an idea of sort of what the Orthodox faith is and sort of how we worship God in our own way.
Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Sure. So our St. Nicholas Church, one of the things that is most striking to a visitor is the pictures throughout the walls and the ceiling throughout the church. And these are the icons. And they adorn our churches and they give us a pictorial representation of the different events of Christ's life, some of the saints, the models who have shown the faith to us, and really help us to communicate better with God.
Oh, well, that's really, really good. Okay.
We're also going to have an exhibit throughout the church that's going to be set up called The Faces of God. And it's going to describe iconography, pictures, artwork about Christ from the time of after his resurrection and ascension. We're going to talk about through the Roman times, the Byzantine Empire, right up until the Renaissance period. So it's given the different idea, the different masterpieces through the years, the Michelangelos to the more traditional Byzantine art that you would see in Greece, in Russia, and in Constantinople.
Wow, so there will be a lot of rich history there as well. So you have a variety of activities for children and adults. So what makes it so special, Father?
The warmth of the people. Mm-hmm. It's a time to have an afternoon, an evening, and just relax. Mm-hmm. You know, one of the thoughts about when someone goes to Greece is just be able to go out and eat, mingle with people, share with people, even strangers that are sitting at the table next to you, talk about sports, politics, or the weather, whatever mm-hmm. it might be, but just an enjoyable, relaxing environment mm-hmm. With good food.
Oh, wow. Now, let's talk about the food. Now, you're going to utilize your own vendors.
Yeah, we have our own people within the community cook. Mm-hmm. We have our lamb dinners, our chicken dinners.
Wow.
We have our pastizio, which is, it's macaroni with cream sauce on top.
Cream sauce?
Yeah. It's very rich and wonderful. Many of the platters that we have in our buffet line, our kitchen line, really can be shared by two people. There's enough food for two.
Okay.
Many of the items can be bought a la carte.
Wow.
If I like to pick and choose, we have dolmades, which are wrapped. They're grape leaves that are wrapped with ground beef, rice, and seasoning. Mm. We also have one that's vegetarian.
Yes.
Without the meat. It's very, very delicious.
I enjoy them both. I didn't know that was a Greek item, though.
Yeah.
Is it? Someone, did you bring any of that today?
I think they dropped some off last week. The ladies of the community just do a fantastic job.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it's unbelievable how good it is, and everyone's got to take a box home.
Okay. And Jim, what's your favorite pastry?
My favorite's the baklava, which is the biggest seller there.
It is. And that's kind of sticky. But it's good.
It's got some honey on top of it,
yeah.
But it's delicious.
Yeah, what's that in the inside of it?
Phyllo and walnuts. It's all ground up and a lot of butter.
A lot of butter. With all this going on,
cinnamon.
Are there any activities to burn all this food off there?
There's a lot of room to walk around, to visit, around the area of the church. Mm-hmm. We encourage everyone to join us dancing.
Okay.
We try in the evening after one of our groups dance. We try to encourage people to get up and learn a few of the dances and just have an enjoyable time.
Okay.
After they have their meal, we have our pastries. We also have coffee.
Mm-hmm. Do you guys have black coffee?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
We have a little, what we call Greek coffee, which is a little bit stronger.
Like it's real, real dark black.
Very dark. Dark brown.
Oh, okay.
Dark brown.
Okay.
It's stronger than Starbucks.
Okay. Wow. Something stronger than Starbucks.
But it's very, very good. And with it, we also have frappes there, which are very great. And with that, for another little sweeter, we call our honey balls, they're called lucamadas, which is dough that's fried and sprinkled again with honey and cinnamon.
I think I've had those.
Oh.
Those are good. Yeah, those are really, really good.
And Sunday afternoon, we're having a lucamada eating contests.
What?
For someone who would like to take that challenge on.
Oh, my goodness. Now, do you participate in that?
That one, no.
Okay. And what about you, Jim?
I'll be sitting that one out.
Okay. Well, what, both of you, tell me, what's your most memorable moment at any previous festival?
You know, when we see all the children from our community and then the adults, not only of our community and outside, joining together on Friday, Saturday, Sunday evening, dancing together, having a good family time, wholesome time.
Mm-hmm.
You see grandparents, you see young adults, you see small children just enjoying themselves in a wonderful evening atmosphere that we have here in our summers in Michigan.
Right.
It's the best of time.
Yeah. So tell us the dates.
It's June 26th, 27th, 28th, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Friday, we're open from 4 to 11, Saturday from noon until 11, and Sunday, noon to 8.
Okay.
And each day, we're going to have different activities. We have a Greek Iron Chef on the 3 days. One day will be hors d'oeuvres, one day will be desserts, another day will be main entree items.
Mm-hmm.
Also on Sunday, Madeline Trifon, who's a master sommelier, will be matching Greek wines and Greek food.
You're not old enough to drink.
I am.
You are.
Yeah.
You don't look it. Okay. So the wines.
And that's gonna be exciting because Greek wine is, we've really seen an influx of Greek wines into America in the last 20 years. Some very, very good wines that people are not familiar with. We're all familiar with many of our own American wines, but I think they'd be very excited to taste some of our Greek wines that'll be also for sale.
Okay. Now, are they red and white?
Yes.
Wow. That sounds good. So, Jim, is there anything else you'd like to add about the festival?
It's just a wonderful place to go out and just spend a wonderful evening trying some Greek foods, trying some Greek dances, and just getting a whole new taste for a different culture, and which is a culture that I've grown up in, a culture that I love.
Yeah. Now, before we close, will there be any shopping or any garments there?
We do have some vendors. We'll have a variety of... They'll have some clothing. They'll have some Greek items, you know, T-shirts, icons, cookbooks. Because everybody, once they taste, they say, well, how do we make this?
Right.
And we're always willing to share, but there are many different cookbooks for the different items that we have, both as pastries and entrees. Mm-hmm. I think they will very much enjoy.
Okay. So is there any other way to contact or get any other information regarding the festival?
Opafest.org. Mm-hmm. And we have handicapped parking on our premises.
Oh, very good.
But our good friends at Walsh College allow us to use their parking lot, which means it's easy parking. Mm-hmm. We have shuttles that come by every 10 minutes.
Oh, we'll
that's
great. Pick
you up and drop you off at the front door.
That's great.
And there's no worries then.
No
worries.
Everyone
get there back and forth very easily.
Yeah, and we'll just pray for great weather. It should be by then.
Three good days.
Three good days of great, great weather. Mm-hmm. Well, it's been really a pleasure.
Well,
meeting
you,
Father.
Thank you,
and you too, Jim.
Thank you
and
very
I wish
much.
You guys success at the festival. And just eat some more of that, flaming cheese?
Saganaki.
How do you say?
Saganaki.
Oh, okay. Well, I'm not going to say that. I'll leave that to you.
Hopefully we see you there.
Okay, that would be really nice. Thank you.
Thank you.
All right. Well, that'll do it for us here at Reaching Out. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next time.